right, we're going to go to Ed in Kalina, California, another Immaculate Heart Radio listener. Hi, Ed. We got about 2 minutes. Fire away.
Oh, hi. I was just wondering, I know, and I appreciate the talk, the masculinity behind spirituality. Now, whenever, sometimes I get frustrated trying to convince Christians close to me about the pro-life movement, and sometimes the arguments are just so ridiculous, especially, you know, when I have these vivid images in my mind of what I'm trying to protect and defend, and you just can't help but get excited. Now, have you ever, and is it ever appropriate to just, you know, get aggressive in language and say, you know, like a drill sergeant would, you know, to if you're trying to, you know, help that combat person, you know, save his own life, right? So you get on them real harsh so they don't forget. Have you ever used that kind of tactic in defending Christ?
I don't know if it's a tactic, but I think, you know, I train people in the ninja art. I'll push them around sometimes so they know that their stance is not working right and, you know, they're not being alert, and I kick them in the face or something, you know. There's a way that you can be aggressive with other men, but not being, I don't even want to use the word aggressive, but men like tough men. So there's a time to be tough. I remember when my son was being bullied, I said, you're going to have to beat him up, and then maybe he'll be your best friend. So I don't mean there's a time to really, you know, exude a lot of anger, but there is a point when it's good to be a man and let him see, you know, how you really feel, but not to be offensive, but call a spade or however you want to say it. I think you have to be prayerful about that. You certainly don't want to act out in any sort of anger, but I think it's good to see that. But you can't do that unless you first have shown a lot of love to that person. If you haven't served that person and shown a lot of love and you haven't spent time in prayer, then you have no right to do that. But I know this. I have a certain friend who's an atheist, and I get tough with him sometimes, but he gets tough back with me. But, you know, main thing is I spend a lot of time in prayer for Crazy Todd, the man who towed my son into 70-foot surf.
Oh,
yeah,
wow.
80-foot surf, yeah.
All right. Appreciate the call and the question, Ed.